On last week's episode of Dirt Tracks, we covered day one of our three-day ghost town tour in the Arizona desert. Traveling with R-Max ATVs and exploring all kinds of cool abandoned mines was amazing, but this was a three-day adventure and there's still two more days to go. So stay tuned to this week's episode for the remainder of the story.
You're talking about a real adventure. This is the first time, as many trips as I've been on with Yamaha, this is the first one that I've had that we're actually coming out and camping and going again and camping. So we went through some rocks yesterday, went through some desert yesterday, which was totally awesome. Then we come back here to this awesome campsite, set up camp, and I got to cook dinner last night. We did some tacos, some flat meat that I had marinated, and then got up this morning, got everything cleaned up. Got them some breakfast going, breakfast burritos with leftover steaks, some potatoes and eggs, and yeah, I think everybody's having a great time so far and looking forward to the adventure today. So,
had a wicked breakfast. Got our tents packed up, got everything packed up, and ready to roll. Everybody had a pretty interesting night last night with the wind. It was like crazy wind all night, but sleeping outside like this, it's just so peaceful. It's amazing. I think everybody had a really good time. We got another big day, 80 plus miles today. And a few more things to see on the way, so more adventure to be had in our trusty R-Maxes.
As good as mine, man. Come up with a million stories on how this thing got here.
It's like the flood brought it.
Yeah.
And deposited it here.
Do you even think how this got out here? It was wild.
How long has it been?
Somebody drove it out here, it broke down, and they said, well, start walking.
Hell yeah. Can we camp here?
Tyler was driving.
Pump the brakes. This guy was driving.
Trying to keep up with Villapoto, which we all know is probably too hard to do. We had dust thrown in our face and ran into a giant divot.
Came prepared with all the right parts that we needed to get this thing back up and running. That's exactly what we're going to do. So, small bump in the road. That's all.
Crazy. Several people have lived here. No more outhouse. Damn.
Oh well.
The little thing in there is the lady that owned the mine. She owned the mine. It did silver, gold, copper. Crazy. Holding up pretty well for being built when it was. It's pretty cool.
Oh, worth saying if it's already said. Even if it all goes over your head, believe it if you want to. So keep your eyes on the road and your head in the stars. Follow it down the rabbit hole just a little while longer. You can change anything if you want to. Sing it like ooh, if you want to. Sing it like ooh, if you want to.
So today we are headed from here at Alamo Lake, and we're gonna go to another old mine that's called McCracken Mine. Really cool history in the area. They've got an old cabin there that's still really well preserved. Some neat rocky trails coming and leading up to it. And then we're gonna go back through Joshua Tree Forest that we went through on day one, fill up with fuel, and then head out to what's called Boreana Mine. There's a really cool little mining structure there, and then we've got a cool pond that's got a surprise in it for the guys. And then we're gonna head back up in the mountains to Hualapai Mountain Lodge, where we'll finish out the trip.
It's peanut butter on this gorge.
Oh, right, what's up?
Like, thanks for trying to kill me, bro. Appreciate you.
Peanut butter and syrup on pancakes is the only way to go. I've been just...
I think I might eat a lot of pancakes today. They're really good.
Stash them in the side-by-side.
My pockets. I'm going to put pancakes in my pockets for later.
It's set up, it looks like it was just like a little bar type of hangout, people that were hunting or something.
Mining.
Yeah.
All the cabins, all the structures we've come to, especially this one's been in relatively good shape. Cool to check out, see some old, you know, old things that they've found through this old mine. I guess this whole hillside was a mine back in the day. So a lot of the shafts or all the shafts that we've seen have been closed off so you can't get into them, but it's really cool to see old stuff like this, man. It's we're lucky to have it here in Arizona just because it's so dry, things last forever. So as long as we don't have people, you know, messing it up or tearing it down, it'll be here for a long time.
Crazy. Hey, there's our lunch. I'm gonna jump in there like a cat.
Definitely ain't catching one.
He'd have to be about this big.
I will actually give you a sizable spear? Amount of money if you do that.
So this is just must be a spring out of the ground, huh? I'm surprised nobody hasn't come up here and built like a concrete, like hot tub or like splash pool when it's 120 out in summer.
It probably gets hot from the water. It's not very deep.
Maybe it's
this
acid.
Water probably gets really hot.
Acid water.
Yeah.
Melts your skin off.
all in all, I think it was a great trip. I mean, it was all everybody from different parts of the world. Yeah, I think we all got along great, and yeah, it just worked. Because a lot of times you get along or get around people, they're like, I don't know about them, but yeah, I think we all meshed really well. At least I did. Anyway, I had a great time.
Whole trip was kind of meh, to be honest. Yeah, I'm out of here.
A whole bunch of different guys coming in, and that's one thing that you don't really know. Okay, we know the machines are going to be good. We know that we're going to see some pretty cool stuff, but then sometimes you get some, you know, groups that are like, oh, you know, like, I could go without that guy or this guy or that guy. So this group's actually been really, really awesome. You know, it's good to be able to get out, sit around a campfire, no cell service, and, you know, just really have some pretty good conversation with people that you've never met before that have, you know, that are into the same types of things that I'm into.
Trip was awesome, man. Great time, great experience, great people. Had a blast. Hopefully we get to do it again someday.
Yeah, definitely signing me up for another trip like this. You know, I love being out, and any excuse for me to get out of training or out of the everyday life, this is what I want to do. You know, it has been 3 days and I'm ready to take a shower, that's for sure.
That's the end of it. 3 days, just under 270 miles. And boy, did we have some fun. Today was a long one. Almost 120 miles today, and we didn't have any major incidents. We only had two flats, one little incident with the front end on TJ's vehicle, and otherwise we were unscathed for all 3 days, so it's pretty awesome. And I can already hear and feel the shower running.